Hello there, YouTube. Here we are again with the wonderful Peterbilt 379. We're going to run a load here. We'll call this my second video for this truck. Looks like my headlights are on. Now they're on. The truck started. You can see the smoke coming out of the exhaust. Alright, we got a dozer here. Bulldozer. 89,000 pounds going to Colville. Alright, here we go. Let's see if we can make this turn. Curved it. Today we have Arnold Schwarzenegger as the Terminator of our navigation.
Turn left.
There we go. We'll just trust him to give us all our navigation. Since this truck was built long before, sort of GPS.
Keep right. Then turn right.
Auto. High beams. There we go.
Turn right.
And we don't care about red lights.
Continue straight.
Left. What do you want me to do, Arnold? What do you want me to do?
Left.
Left. Okay. Alright, let's get back inside the truck here. Oh, God. This truck doesn't have GPS, and as far as I know, there's no way to get GPS on the dash. We're just going to have to listen to Arnold give us the instructions. Swing it wide. This is kind of a long trailer. If you watched my first video on this truck, showed you the customization and what I went through to make it the way that it is. There's few of you who have actually seen any of these videos.
Keep right.
I'm trying to keep it interesting. Y'all just gotta watch, keep up, and keep going. Just keep watching. I mentioned it lightly in my last video. I just had a baby September 13th, which was Friday.
Keep left. And then continue straight. Continue straight.
Thank you. I don't know what gear I'm in. Fucking watch this long. Where are we going? Come on. Tell me something else.
Left.
Thank you. No, left. There it is. Okay, I found it. Just to the top right of the steering wheel. About 1 o'clock, maybe 2 o'clock on the steering wheel. It's raining. It's dark. We're not going to see a whole lot of this truck. And I got rid of my HUD, so I don't even know what time it is. Little history lesson here. This Peterbilt 359 was built between the years of 1966 and 1986. Stopped production in 1986 on the 359 to make the 379. Pull the hill. How much did I say this was? 86,000 pounds. A lot of weight for this little truck. I got the biggest engine that I could put in this thing. And we're still falling flat on our face. There's the truck beside me. Well, not no more. I think I just scared the bejesus out of it. Whoopsie. Fine. I'll just get on over here. Realistic rain mod. Looks a whole lot better. 6 modes of wipers, although I'm not terribly sure it works on this truck. But this truck seems to have a reasonable set of wiper modes, so deal with that. Why do people like to stop in front of me? Drop a gear. Good.
going up there smoking watching. Yakima.
No, we don't need to go there. We're going to Colville, everybody.
Keep left.
Okay. We will keep left, Arnold. If you say so. Hey, we're over 65 now. There we go. Some speed to us.
Woohoo!
Third person, but it's kind of dark right now. You're not really going to see much. Scenic view. No, we don't need that. Star Wars speed racers. Ah, we dropped down to 15. All in a hill. A lot of weight. This is the life of a truck driver. You go uphill really slow, and then you go downhill really fast. A lot of weight. Usually, if you don't have enough horsepower, you will be going up the hill very, very slow. Too much weight, not enough horsepower. Trying to pass me for here, buddy. What are you doing? Rest there. Well, we don't need that right now. Going down the road. This far, I'll go ahead and tell you, I bought another truck, the Freightliner Classic XL, which on this profile, once I make enough money, I'll do a couple more loads, make some more money, and then I'll buy that truck, and I'll drive it around for a little while. I'll do some reviews on that truck, what I like, what I don't like. The only thing I don't like about this truck is you can't get a GPS monitor on the dash anywhere, which to a certain degree is kind of understandable since GPS didn't exist when this truck was in production, so I can kind of understand it, but it just mounts to the dash. car, you just drill a hole and put a screw in it. Mount your GPS. Put that in anything. But I guess for the realism and the immersion, they left out the option to put up an onboard computer that tells you how many miles till empty on your fuel. You just kind of have to guess at it. Hope you got enough fuel. An eye on it. Granted, yes, I do have an actual fuel gauge on the dash. The speedometer doesn't exactly show me how many miles I have on this truck. I have to do that in the menus and see how many miles. I just kind of like to keep track of how many miles I've got on a truck. So how far have I driven it? Most of the switches and stuff, when you go to like change your headlights and stuff, I don't notice that any of the switches actually work for that. Or like when you turn your jake brake on and off, I don't see a switch on the dash. I mean, granted, it's dark right now, so you can't see the switchboard, but I did test this during daylight, and I flipped all the switches and stuff. None of the switches on the dash seem to work. So that's something they could work on. They could fix that. But then again, on the other hand, that's more animations, and that's more data to load on the RAM. That's more data to load in your video card. That's more video processing. It's more resource heavy and intensive. Have all these animations and make everything work. So I can kind of understand not making all the switches and stuff actually function.
Left.
We don't want to lose a whole lot of FPS on account of just making some switches work on the dash. If they could do it, that would be awesome. I think I've got a big enough video card to handle it. Hopefully one of these days I'll build a bigger computer to run this game a little better. I know some of you are probably sitting here watching this like, how can you play that with all that lag? I'm just kind of used to it. I got the graphics set to the point where I can tolerate the amount of lag that's going on. It's not really all that bad. I could crank the graphics up more and get a whole bunch more lag.
Keep right, and then exit right. I insist.
Okay, if you insist, we'll do it.
Exit right. I insist.
All right, now what, Arnold? Where are we going? Gonna tell us. He's gonna keep it a secret. Alright, let's check our handy dandy map and see exactly where we're going. Okay, we need to turn left. We're in Spoken. We're at the end of the map. Okay, we cut left and follow this up to Colville. Once we get past the Walgreens and the FedEx, we take a right and then a left. Okay, so from where we are, we cut left. Alrighty. Anybody coming? Nope. See a bunch of lag right there. This truck is rather resource heavy. My video card's really hot right now. 52 degrees Celsius. That's pretty warm. I got a EVGA video card, and I've got the accompanying software to go with it, the Precision X1 software that allows me to go in and set my fan speed. Video card's running pretty warm. Usually on the SCS 389, it doesn't run this hot.
Continue straight.
This truck is a little bit more resource heavy than the SCS trucks, but I'm not getting too bad of video lag on here, so I'm not really upset about it. So we'll just blow this red line. Lane road, all the way up to Colville. Brake check me. Did you see that? He brake checked me. I think we're in town. I think we hit Colville. Yep. And we got a roundabout. There's a roundabout in Colville.
Ahead. Exit right. Exit right, I insist.
Okay.
continue straight.
Okay. I will do, Honorable.
I will continue straight.
That was Russian. That was fine.
Ahead. Turn right.
Okay.
Turn right.
I don't see anybody. Anyway, alright. We'll just go ahead and swing this wide. Can't see a whole lot here. Alright, we're around the corner. Okay, well, we obviously cannot go that way.
Turn left.
Alright.
Turn left.
Okay. BHP Billiton. Swing it wide. Alright. There we go.
Ahead. Turn right. Turn right.
Okay. I hope this is right. There it is. There's our delivery location. Let's see if we can get this thing put in the spot.
You've arrived. Hasta la vista, baby.
Hasta la vista, baby. That's enough to get the trailer where it needs to be. Nailed it! Whew. Well, that was interesting. Alright. And I leveled up. What do we want? We got all our hazmats. Let's go high value cargo. Let's go with that. New upgrades for trailers. Side skirts. Bunch of stuff. Sliding tarps. What do we get for trucks? If it'll load. There we go. Gun steering wheel, Excalibur flight, ace with black lines, headache racks on the 389, 389, 579, 579, 579. That's it. And of course, stuff for. Load. There it goes. Okay, just about all the same stuff for Kenworth. Bull bars. Dual intake for the K100E, which I will do a video of one day. I will do the K100E. I have it. Obviously, I have it, so I will do a video of it. I also have the old style 70s Kenworth K900. Or the W900 from Smokey and the Bandit. I've got the full mod to paint the truck. The right truck from the movie. The paint job to go with that truck, and then the owned trailer graphic scheme to go with the Smokey and the Bandit, which I will do a video of the Smokey and the Bandit edition truck eventually. So if you've watched this far, you've got something to look forward to. Alright, so we'll just save here. And if you liked the video, hit like. If you want to see more videos, hit subscribe and ring the little bell. Other than that, have a good day. We'll catch you later. Buh-bye.